The opinions expressed in the following program are not necessarily those of Eastlink TV, its sponsors, or partners.
Hello. Welcome to Cool Science. My name is Jonathan. We're here in Space Place today at Science North, and I'm going to show you the science of rocket fuel. Now, the simplest rocket is really just a balloon. You've got your container for the fuel, you've got the nozzle where it comes out. If I blow up this balloon, it's full of air, and all that air wants to escape, and there's only one place for that air to come out. When it comes out the bottom, the balloon is going to go up. This is something called Newton's third law of motion. For every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. If the action is the air coming out, the reaction is the balloon going up. So let's launch this rocket. Ready for liftoff? 3, 2, 1. So real rockets are a lot heavier than a balloon, so they need a stronger force to get them into the air. That force is called thrust. Instead of just compressing gases inside a balloon, they actually burn them and combust these gases. And then all of the heat and energy from that combustion rushes out the nozzle of the rocket. So we're going to make some of that fuel. Here I've got a little container full of salt water, and I'm going to run some electricity through it. When I do, that electricity is going to change the water. It's going to break it apart. So as I'm cranking this, there are going to be little bubbles coming out of the ends of the pencils. These are the electrodes in the water. And those bubbles are the gas that we're going to use for our rocket fuel. To show you what's happening to the water, I have a little tiny model here. So water is also known as dihydrogen monoxide, or H2O. What that means is that we have two atoms of hydrogen attached to one atom of oxygen. Now, when we're putting electricity into the water, we're breaking apart the water, breaking apart the bonds between the atoms so that the hydrogens stick together and become a gas. And then the oxygen becomes a gas too. So for every two molecules of water, we get two molecules of hydrogen gas and one molecule of oxygen gas. So I've got a bigger machine over here that's doing the very same thing. I'm running electricity through a little container of water here, and it's breaking it apart into the hydrogen gas and the oxygen gas. I'm collecting it in this tube, and then I'm going to let both of those gases mix together in this bag. I think we should be just about ready. Now we'll see just how much energy is contained inside this tiny amount of those two gases, hydrogen and oxygen. Ready for liftoff? 3, 2, 1. So you can hear and see the power that came from just a tiny amount of those two gases mixing together. Now imagine an entire rocket full of hydrogen and oxygen burning together. And you've probably seen all this smoke coming out of the back of a rocket when it launches. And it looks like an awful lot of pollution, but think about what we're combining. We had our hydrogen and our oxygen, and when we burn them together, we're getting back all of the energy that it took to break those bonds and separate them. And the end result is water. And that is rocket science. I'm Jonathan. Thanks for joining me on Cool Science. See you next time.